Hello students, today we are going to study our next topic, that is degradation of soil and conservation measures. We'll discuss here in this video the degradation of soil and conservation measures. Okay, you take out your book and you see the topic. First of all, our soil, the top layer of the earth, that means soil, which is degraded by various means, which are eroded, and erosion occurs by various means and degradation occurs by various means. It may be by a natural factor, it may be by human factors. So some of the factors I have included here, you can see in your screen, the factors which lead to the soil degradation. The number one is overgrazing. Overgrazing means the feeding of the animals. Okay, the overgrazing is first factor. Second one is overuse of chemical fertilizers or pesticides. We use chemical fertilizer as well as pesticides in the crop field, which degraded the soil natural quality. Soil water holding capacity, soil fertility holding capacity is degraded by the chemical fertilizer and pesticide, which is also lead to the soil degradation. The third one is rain wash. You can say by the rainwater, the surface runoff. When rain occurs, then the water run through the surface of the soil, the surface of the land. Water run through this surface runoff, the soil, the top layer of the earth is degraded and rapid rain. So rain wash is also one of the important factors for soil degradation. Next one, number four, that is landslide. When landslide occurs in the in high hill areas, also in the high hill slopes, that areas is basically you will see the soil degradation. Next one is flood. Flood is also important factors for soil degradation. Where flood occurs occasionally in that area, the soil degraded very fast rate. So these are some factors which increase the rate of soil degradation. You should remember these five factors. First one is overgrazing, overuse of chemical fertilizers or pesticides, rain wash, landslide, as well as flood. The rain wash, flood, these are some natural factor, but overgrazing, it is a human made factor. Overuse of chemical fertilizer or pesticide, it is a human made factor. And landslide also, it is a human made factors. Okay, there I have included all human made and natural factors. Next, you see these factors increase the rate of soil degradation, but there have some measures through which we can we can control the soil erosion. These are we will discuss some methods, some measures of soil conservation. You see, the first one is mulching. Mulching, I have plotted here number one, that is mulching. Mulching is a process where the organic substances like straw, like grasses, dry grasses, we can plot between two row of tree, between two row of tree where there have a bare ground. We can use straw and dry grasses to control the soil erosion. You can see the picture. There are two rows or two lines of trees. In between there have some straw and dry grasses. By plotting these dry grasses, by patching these dry grasses and straw, we can control the soil erosion. Okay, see the mulching. Mulching means the bare ground between the plants is covered with a layer of organic matter like straw, which helps to retain the soil moisture. If rainfall occurs, rain will not flow, rainwater will not flow. It will stop here, it will catch by this dry grasses or straw. So it helps the keeping the soil moisture. The water in the soil, it helps to keep. So this way soil can be conserved and it can be the soil erosion can be reduced. Next one is contour barrier. You can see here the contour barrier. It is a hill slope. You can see two picture here. The people have made some wall make some wall by natural by naturally, or by the plotting some rocks, plotting some stone, plotting the wood, okay, maybe plotting some soil also. The people have made some barrier, and they have made some terraces. In terraces they used to do the cultivation, and this row or this wall of rocks or wall of stones, it reduced the soil like soil erosion, soil erosion, and it reduced the flowing down of water from high hill slope to downward. Okay, this is contour barrier. The stone, see the what is contour barrier. The stone, grass, soil are used to build the barriers along the contours. Contours means height, along with the height of the terrace. It is important to collect and save water in a plot of land. The barrier or the wall, the stone barrier, which helps in keeping the water, store the water in that plot of land. Okay. Next, you see the rock dam. You can see two picture. The rock dam. If the soil, water is flowing down from high hills, high slope area to downward. If it's flowing down, it erodes the soil in high areas and brings down to the low lying areas. Okay. To stop the soil erosion, to stop eroded materials, we can make some rock dam by plotting rock wall in the stream of the water. There, if we plot rock dam, then it will reduce the soil losses or soil erosion. Okay. This is one type of method through which we can protect the soil, we can save soil. See, rock are piled up to slow down the flow of water. It used to slow down the water, and it prevents the soil losses through gullies. So gullies means small river-like areas, river-like streams. If we give rock dam, then it will slow down the river or slow down the gullies, and it will stop the soil erosion. Okay, it is also an important soil conservation measures. Next, you see terrace farming. You have seen zoom cultivation. You heard the name zoom cultivation in Northeast India. That means people, basically the hill areas people, they used to cultivate in the hill slope areas. In hill slope area, when they are doing cultivation, so they used to do some terrace, small plot of land according to the height of the land. Okay, in between the land, in between the cropping land, they make some barrier. They make some what is called embankments. These embankments protects the soil losses, as well as it reduces the flow of water. Reduces the flow of water. If there are high flow of water, then it will erode more soil. So to protect the high flow of protect the soil, to reduce the flow of water, they used to make some terraces, make some barriers. These are called terrace farming. In Northeast India, this terrace farming, it is called as zooming or zoom cultivation. Okay, see, the broad flat steps or terrace are made on the steep slope so that flat surfaces are available to grow crops. It reduces the surface runoff and soil erosion. In hill areas people, they make flat terrace to grow crop, as well as they make some barrier. They use some barrier to reduce the surface runoff, the flow of water, and it also protects soil erosion in the hill slope areas. Next, you see intercropping. It is one of the important method in basically a states like Assam, as well as basically the states of Northeast India. Intercropping is very important method for soil conservation. Intercropping means, the term indicate intercropping. Cropping means doing cultivation. Okay, intercropping, that means in a plot of land, the farmers used to do different types of crops together. Different types of crops together. That means you can see in the picture, there you will see some मेज कल्टीवेशन एज वेल एज सम वेजिटेबल्स कल्टीवेशन और द स्पिनस टाइप वेजिटेबल्स कल्टीवेशन दिस लीफी लीफी स्पिनस एक्सेट्रा. सो दैट मीन्स इन इंटरक्रॉपिंग सिस्टम द सम लाइक वन टाइप्स ऑफ क्रॉप्स कैन कल्टिवेटेड इन वन टाइम एंड अनदर काइंड ऑफ क्रॉप्स कैन बी कल्टिवेटेड इन अनदर टाइम. दैट मीन्स डिफरेंट सोइंग एंड हार्वेस्टिंग ऑफ क्रॉप्स बेसिकली यू विल सी इन हियर. दैट मीन्स दे विल कल्टिवेट दे विल हार्वेस्ट दिस वेजिटेबल्स ड्यूरिंग द मंथ ऑफ जून जुलाई बट द मेज कल्टिवेशन दे विल कल्टिवेट इन ड्यूरिंग द month of November, December. That means their sowing period is also different, their harvesting period is also different. You can see here different crops are grown in alternate rows and are sown at different times to protect the soil from the rain wash. That means during the rainwater rainy time, summer season, the soil eroded the rainwater eroded the soil. So to protect soil from that erosion, people do different types of cultivation, different types of crops are grown in a plot of land. Okay, they will do vegetables also, they will do the rice cultivation also. That they will cut the vegetables in month of June, July, and they will cut the rice during the month of November, December. This type of cultivation basically do, and this is called intercropping. Next, you see contour plowing. It is same like terrace cultivation, where the farmers basically select the flat, select the hill slope, and they plow the land. Plowing means they harvest the land, the flat top land, and they also do the barrier to protect from the surface runoff of the water. See here, contour plowing is the practice of plowing fields along the curves of the slope, hill slope. This helps to slow down the runoff and excess rainfall and prevent it from washing the soil away. That means contour barrier as well as terrace cultivation, where farmers do plow in hill slope, where they will give the barrier according to the slope to reduce the surface runoff of the water. Surface runoff means flow of water from the hills, high areas to low areas, and also it protects from soil erosion. Okay, these are also soil conservation methods. Next, you see shelter belt. It is one of the important activity in the dry areas, dry regions, desert region, dry region. You can say in Rajasthan area, Punjab, West Punjab areas, Gujarat areas, this type of cultivation basically done by the farmers. You see the lines of the tree in between the crop field. This lines of the tree, it protects the soil from the wind. Lines of the tree in near to the tree, there have crop field. In their lines of the trees, this lines of the tree, it protects the land from the wind. If wind also blows heavily, wind blows heavily in the dry areas, desert areas. If wind blows heavily, it cannot erode the soil. The topsoil can be eroded by the wind also. Not only rainwater, it erodes by the wind also. So to protect the land from the wind, the people of the dry region and desertic region, they plant trees in parallel line, and these are called shelter belts. Okay, if wind blows also, it will hit in the tree lines, not in the crop field. So if it hit in the tree line, it will go up and it will return there, but it will not erode the soil of that area. See, in the coastal and dry regions, rows of trees are planted to check the wind movement to protect soil cover. In coastal areas means also near to the sea. In these areas also basically the sandy areas, as well as in the dry regions like desertic region, it is also sandy area or dry soil. In that area, wind action we will see to protect the area, protect the soil, the crop land, people basically plant the trees in rows in parallel line. Okay, this is called shelter belt. Okay, this was the basically soil conservation measures. Yeah, you basically soil conservation method. You can see in your book also, it is written in your book also, and you can note down from this video also. Now the next point and next topic means the next point is types of soil in India. You will get different types of soil. Among this, I have plotted some names here. The first one is alluvial soil, which is very fertile. Next one is black soil. Next one is number three, that is red soil. Number four, it is laterite soil. Number five, it is desertic soil, basically sandy soil. And number six, it is mountain soil, which is a very less fertile soil. So these are the basic soil, different kinds of soil basically found in India, as well as most of them are found in Assam also. This type of soils are basically found in Assam also, in different parts of Assam as well as different parts of India. So please go through the book and try to understand. If any confusion, you ask me. Okay, thank you.